What are the impacts of a linear economy on the global community, especially in regards to poverty?
We use our efficiency paradigm as an excuse for consuming even more by completely ignoring the resources circulating right in front of us. A circular economy is not contradicting economic interests. On the contrary, circular design allows companies to improve their profit situation and simultaneously conserving resources and creating more jobs. If we talk about Europe, for example, circular economy will create round about 3 million new jobs by 2030. These effects are even more significant for developing countries.
How can corporations tackle social inequalities and global warming by closing the loop within their supply chains? And also, which role do you see digitalization and new technologies playing here?
We need to use resources in a way that we do not exhaust resource stocks. For designing our products and services, we have to stop using scarce resources, introduce substitutes and facilitate reuse thereof. And what is, from my point of view, the most important task, to ask the right question. Further, we must maintain all products and materials at a high as quality level as possible, so that they can actually be reused. And coming back to the second part of your question, we need transparency in the whole global supply chain. And digitalization is the most effective tool we can use to tackle social and environmental issues in the supply chain.
How can circular economy principles promote prosperity and satisfy the needs of developing countries in order to eradicate poverty?
Because circularity promotes economic growth by creating new businesses and job opportunities, saving material costs and improving the security of supply. One advantage that should not be neglected is the control of price volatility. Countries with a high unemployment rate and low wages get access to a huge overseas market. At the same time, circular economy helps reducing environmental pressure and impacts to curb pollution and mitigate global warming. Circular economies is one of our best chances to end poverty, because circular economy, or in the long run, regenerative business models, have the potential to evolve with a changing planet.
What are the main challenges we face on the way towards a circular economy?
So I would like to mention five different challenges. The first one is we need to meet consumers' expectation for convenience. The second one is that also government regulation may create waste. Many countries do also lack a proper recycling infrastructure. Recycling technology is not good enough in many cases. And finally, the fifth challenge we have to deal with, we have to use, or we are still right now using, the wrong business model. We have to move, we call it, from a mechanistic worldview to a more holistic approach, which supports circular approaches or a more regenerative business model. Companies have to start designing products for circularity.
Especially in the light of the current COVID-19 crisis, in how far do you see circular design having the potential to improve the resilience of supply chains?
COVID-19 interrupted global supply chains immensely. If companies start building products based on already used materials, we would already have them in our economic systems and would not be so dependent on the availability from global supply chains. COVID has shown us that we urgently need to revise our supply chain approach and that we have to rethink about new strategies like the relocalization strategies.
How can we create a more circular economy in Europe?
The European Union has adopted a circular economy action plan in the wake of the so-called Green Deal. A next crucial step is to embrace the relevant stakeholders to achieve the actions outlined in the action plan. If we have a closer look at the action listed in the EU plan, the most important change we have to make is education and training. We have to support companies on this journey in a way that they can successfully implement circularity in their new business models.